Hello everyone, how are you? How was your week? I know the weather was crazy, right? One day it's really hot and one day it's really cold. This is not good because you can catch a cold if you are not careful. Okay, so I already heard that some of you did not feel well last week. So you better take care of yourself because I don't want any one of you to be sick. Amen? Amen. Okay, now let's give a spirit five together. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Spirit five. Excellent job. Everyone, please stand up. We are going to start with the call to worship and opening prayer. And close your eyes and hear me out. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Let the Redeemer of the Lord tell the story. Those He redeemed from the hand of the foe, those He gathered from the lands, from east and west, from north and south. Coming from Psalm 107, verse 1, 2, 3. Let me pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank You for today You have given us. Because we have today, we were able to have another chance to worship You and honor Your name. So let us worship You with everything we have. Let us use our body and spirit only for You. And as we do that, let us remind ourselves what You did for us. You gave the true salvation by giving Your only Son, Jesus Christ. And through Your Son, His death and resurrection, in faith, we became clean and became Your sons and daughters. So help us to focus on You so we can give glory to You, Lord. Furthermore, help those who still don't know You. Let them hear Your word and open their heart, so they can accept You as their Savior and Lord. We thank You for this time and everything. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much. And now we are going to sing Jesus We Enthrone You together. Let's sing.
Jesus, we enthrone You. We proclaim You our King. Standing here in the midst of us, we raise You up with our praise. And as we worship the throne, and as we worship the throne, and as we worship the throne, come Lord Jesus and take Your place. Jesus, we enthrone You. We proclaim You our King. Standing here in the midst of us, we raise You up with our praise. And as we worship in the throne, and as we come Lord Jesus and take Your place.
Good job. And now is our time to confess our sins. So everybody close your eyes and hear me out. Jesus Christ bore our sin in His body on the cross so that we might die to sin and live for righteousness. By His wounds we have been healed. So let us know our failure and disobedience and come back to the Lord with faith. This is our time to remember who Jesus is. Jesus, the Son of God, came to this world as a 100% human being, 100% God. He died on the cross and resurrected on the third day. And whomever believes in Him, through faith alone, yesterday, today, and tomorrow's sins are forgiven. If there are anything you did against God, bring it before Him and ask Him for the forgiveness. And let us pray. Father, Lord, again, we thank You for everything what You have done for us, Lord. We have come to, you know, together to worship You and honor You and glorify Your name. So be with us. And as we spend this time to, you know, repenting our sin, hear us out. Let us truly put down ourselves before You and worship You with everything we have, Lord. We want to glorify Your name because we know that You are the true God. Lord, be with us throughout from the beginning to the end. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, we give thanks again for giving us the time to ask for forgiveness. We know that we are sinners before You and nothing before You. However, with Your Son's death and resurrection, we who are sinners were saved from forever death. And we who believe in Your Son want to give this moment to You, only for You, Lord, because You are the true God who is the Most High. So accept this worship. And as we give glory to You, let us experience Your love and grace. And let us rejoice and shout Your name on high. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, everybody. And now we are going to recite assurance of forgiveness on three. 1, 2, 3. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John chapter 1, verse 9. And this is the praise time. Let's do it.
Got a rhythm in my heart and in my soul. Got a reason for this joy I can't control. I wanna sing, I wanna dance, and give everyone a chance to hear about this endless love I know. What You give to me is not for me to keep, it's for the world to see Your love.
Give a little kindness, give a little kindness, give a little.
there's you, and there's a very different me. Touchdown, you had me at believe, you had me at believe you did. And where would I be without you, without you? I'd be packing my bag when I need to stay. I'd be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'd be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you.
Old things have passed away, your love has stayed the same, your constant grace remains the cornerstone. Things that we thought were dead, breathing in life again. You cause your sun to shine on darkest nights. For all that you've done, we will pour out our love. This will be our anthem song. Jesus, we our devotion poured out on the feet of Jesus.
Great job, everybody. And now we are going to recite Apostles' Creed together. If you memorized it, I want you to close your eyes and recite it with one voice. If you didn't, I want you to read it out loud with one voice together, okay? Everybody on three. One, two, three. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Universal Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Amen. And now I want you to get your Bibles out and open up to Proverbs chapter 14, and we are going to read verse 2. All right, Pastor Joon is going to read it out loud for you, so listen carefully. Whoever fears the Lord walks uprightly, but those who despise him are devious in their ways. Amen. And it was the word of the Lord coming from Proverbs chapter 14, verse 2. And today, Pastor Joon is going to come up and give us the God's word with the title, The Mature Wisdom. Hear him out. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Sunday worship. Like everyone knows, today is the last Sunday for May, which means the next month is June. It also means that I will meet some new friends who register for June worship. So are you ready? I hope you're excited, just like I am excited. But for those of you who couldn't register for June worship, don't worry, because July worship registration is going to come very soon. Anyways, let's start, everyone. As you guys know, we are focusing on reading the book of Proverbs. And on the first Sunday of May, Pastor Joon was able to share that the book of Proverbs is known as one of the wisdom books of Hebrew scripture, because the main purpose of this book is to teach wisdom to people. Not the wisdom of this world, but the wisdom of God. Furthermore, the book of Proverbs also teaches us an importance of gaining the wisdom of God, because that wisdom establishes our relationship with God. So I told you, in coming weeks, by going over the book of Proverbs, I'm going to teach you the requirements of gaining the true wisdom from God. And do you remember how many requirements? That's right. I said 4. humility, purity, faithfulness, and maturity. And yes, we did go over first three already. So today we are going to focus on the last requirement, which is maturity today. The mature wisdom. Now, to focus on maturity, we were able to read from the book of Proverbs, chapter 14. So what does it say? In chapter 14, verse 2, we see that it says, "Whoever fears the Lord walks uprightly, but those who despise him are devious in their ways." From here, we understand the importance of fearing the Lord. Wait, Pastor Joon, fearing the Lord? Why? What does it mean to fear the Lord? Isn't fear a bad thing? Fearing the Lord is not a bad thing, everyone. But you need to understand what it means. The fearing the Lord does not mean that you need to get scared by the Lord. This is totally different than the time when you were scared by ghost stories or being in a dark room. The real meaning of fearing the Lord is for you to understand that God is the one who loves you so much, and also God is just. The word fear is used here because of the fear of losing God. Would you like to lose someone who loves you? The God who gave you everlasting love. What if he stopped loving you now? Because of your sinful act, you will be devastated. Think of it this way. You have parents who love you, but one day they say they don't love you anymore because you did a bad thing. How would you feel? This is one of the things that we don't want to think about. Just like that, we fear to lose God, especially due to our sin. This is what fearing the Lord means. We know that God is there to watch us every day, giving his love to us through Jesus. We fear that we might disappoint God with sin, and because of that, he might leave us. Not only that, we do fear the Lord because God is just. He is the one who hates sin, and he is the one who will judge all of us if we sin. Therefore, we don't want to do anything against him. These are what fearing the Lord means. Then, Pastor Joon, what about maturity? Well, everyone, the reason why we were reading the book of Proverbs, chapters 14, is because it focuses on maturity. How? I want you to know that only mature people are the one who understands what to fear and who to fear. Because mature believers are the one who has the strong faith in Jesus. We use the word mature in many ways. We use the word mature when a person is fully grown, from a young child to an adult. We also use the word mature when we see our body changes from young to old. But the maturity we use in Christianity is different. We use it when a believer of Jesus is a faithful follower who has Jesus in the center of their belief and who is living in the Word of God and who continues to walk in Jesus with the help of Holy Spirit. When we see that, we say the person is mature Christian. And this mature Christians are the one who does not hinder in spiritual fight. There might be challenges and temptations from a people who has a lying lips. Mature Christians will never hinder because they fear the Lord and they understand who to fear. And they seek the truth and seek God for the answer. We can look into two different characters in the Bible. One is Abraham and another is Jonah. Abraham is one of the perfect examples as mature believers, and Jonah is someone who was not mature. I want you to remember the time when God asked Abraham to sacrifice his own son. What did he do? Yes, you're right. He obeyed God. He took his son to the place where he sacrificed. He tied his son and grabbed his knife. And he tried to end his son's life for the sacrifice. And we saw at the moment where he was about to stab his son, God spoke to Abraham to stop. From here, we saw how mature Abraham was. He was the one who was faithful to God. On the other hand, unlike Abraham, we saw Jonah disobeying God when he asked Jonah to go to Nineveh. Instead of going to Nineveh, Jonah got into the boat where it was going to take him to Tarshish. Due to his disobedience, according to the Bible, we see that Jonah was eaten by a big fish for 3 days and 3 nights. And from this story, we can see the person who is not mature. And because he was not mature, he never understood how to fear the Lord. So everyone, let me ask you this question. Are you mature? Today's passage is informing us to fear the Lord. I'm telling you, we cannot fully understand why and how to fear the Lord unless we are mature. And yes, many of you are still very young. However, you must know young age does not mean that you cannot be mature. Because there are so many older people who are not mature too. I hope you can understand what I tried to say today. And just like King David, when he was able to defeat Goliath, I hope you can be a mature person who are faithful to God so you can defeat the Goliath. Amen. So for 4 Sundays, we were able to focus on the requirements of gaining the true wisdom from God. Humility, purity, faithfulness, and maturity. These 4, just remember, if you truly seek for the wisdom of God, this is what you need. You need to remind yourself to be humble, pure, faithful, and mature. If you do that, you can surely establish the relationship with God and gain the wisdom of God. Amen. Amen. Let me pray, everybody. Father, Lord, again, we thank you for everything what you have done for us, Lord. Today's message was very important for us. We need to be mature to require to gain the wisdom from you. Lord, be with each one of the children out there, Lord. Be with the people who are able to listen to this word. Let us be a mature person who is defined as the mature Christianity, the believer of Jesus Christ. Be with each one of us. Just work with us so we could truly glorify your name in your kingdom and for your kingdom. We thank you. We ask you again to guide us in every step. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, everybody, and now is the offering time. And if you have the offering basket, I want you to pull it out. And if you have an offering, I want you to put it in the basket and go around to collect it from your family. The reason we are doing this is so that we could remind ourselves who God is. God, who is the creator of this world, have given us every single thing in our life. By remembering that, we are giving back the partial thing to our God so we could glorify him and his kingdom. All right, let's do that, and we are going to sing doxology together. Let's sing. Thank you. And today we have Grace Teacher who is going to pray for our offering prayer. And let's pray, everybody.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this beautiful Sunday morning and letting us to be able to worship you and to praise you. Lord, please guide us each and every day so that we may follow by your words. And please guide us with wisdom and that we may continue to have faith in you. And Lord, let us just continue to pray without ceasing and always be joyful in everything that we do. We just thank you for everything Lord has given us. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Grace Teacher. And now we are going to recite Lord's Prayer. If you memorized it, I want you to close your eyes. And if you didn't, I have it on the screen. I want you to read it out loud with one voice, okay? Everyone, on three. One, two, three. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Announcement time, everyone. Number one, we have BRC, the Bible Reading Challenge. I want you to continue reading it and keep it strong. We're still in Genesis, and I still think you can catch up if you didn't start yet, okay? All right, number two, we have breakout session every Sunday at 2 p.m. If you're attending the worship in church in person, then you don't have to come into the breakout session in Zoom. But if you want to, the options are open. You can, all right? I'm just letting you know about that. And number three, the memory verse competition is going to happen in June 13 at 2:30 p.m. in Zoom. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 to 8. I want you to try to memorize it, and I want you to compete, all right? And number four, we have fifth graders barbecue coming in Zoom. And I think it's going to be on the third Saturday of June, but I will make sure to confirm with you by, you know, tomorrow, okay? And number five, graduation service for fifth grader is going to happen very soon in June too. Pastor Joon is going to inform you soon as it's confirmed too, but I think it's going to happen in online. But I'll let you know as soon as possible. And number six, I have to tell you, Joon worship is going to start from next week. And if you register for Sunday worship in person, I need you to come and participate and join us, okay? Because you're holding the spot for other people. I want you to remember. Now, if you didn't register for in-person worship in June, we have July worship coming up and the registration will start very soon. Okay, and now birthdays. Ba-bum!
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, everyone, my love. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, everybody, and stay safe and be healthy all the time. Just remember, this is not the end because we got Zoom meeting very soon. I hope I could see you there, and I love you. And bye-bye.